Okay, so I already hit you with the defense soap thing, but yeah. First things first. You're that matched, you know, like it comes down to one takedown.
Yeah.
But it doesn't come down to one takedown, it comes down to not quitting.
Yeah.
Normally in that situation, 99 out of 100 times, the other guy wins.
Yeah.
What's going through your head with 10 seconds left?
I've been trying to push the pace this last 3 periods in all my matches. Whether or not I get off to a big lead or a slow start, I'm trying to work on my 3rd period, and that's what I've been doing throughout this season. So to actually get it, to execute it, came down to me having to score to win the match. And, it was nice to actually get the W in this position, because sometimes I'm usually the one getting chased down. So through my head, I was just staying composed and staying in good position. I knew with time, if I kept my pressure on him, some things would start to open up. That's what happened. I got able to get to my ties. I got a little blast double, got his arms reaching. I pumbled under, and he was heavy on his left foot, and I kicked it out with a hip toss. And hopefully maybe with 3 seconds left, I would have got the fall there, but I'm grateful for the 2. So
you didn't even get any near fall. You realize that?
I know.
That's crazy. So you did it right at the buzzer, right?
Yeah, I think that I knew there was 5 seconds left, and I just pulled the trigger, got my underhooks, and then just hip tossed him. I know I got like 1 swipe or something, and he bellied down at him right there. And I was just like, I'm comfortable with the takedown. But yeah, a fall would have been huge there for the win. Team win 2 there.
And you've been on the other end of like disappointing losses. I was at your George Mason match. You lost a match you were dominating.
Yeah.
Right? The whole regulation, then he gets you in overtime, right?
That's what I was talking about. Like, for me, if not many people know, but I wrestled at Buffalo. I got hurt. So I haven't wrestled for 1.5 years, like competing. So me coming back to Cleveland State, they gave me an opportunity. It took a little adjustment period to get back into the competition phase. So early in the season, it was just getting a feel back for it. And then building my shape up, and it's near the end of the season, I feel great. My shape's under me, my lungs are under me, and I feel confident in my attacks and offense.
What's it like being off 1.5 years of your wrestling career in the prime of it, right?
Yeah.
With injuries, whatever else was going on. And then how refreshing has the transfer been from Buffalo to Cleveland, right? How different is that?
So it's a unique story with me, because if you hear people, you got people taking breaks from wrestling, and if you take that long of a break, you never come back to the sport. That's honestly how some people have, especially 1.5 years. It was hard. It's hard, going through practices, not competing, but being there to support your teammates at your old school, transitioning to a new school, you get respect by busting your butt in the room. So just come in working hard, you get back into the swing of things. Especially with a great team, great supporting staff, coaching, it was an easy transition.
PA, you're from PA, you go to New York, then you're in Ohio. Where do you end up next?
Yeah, I don't know, it's crazy. I had 2 other brothers that wrestled, my younger brothers at UVA, my brother went to Rutgers. So it's weird, we're all 4 hours from Pittsburgh in different directions. So I don't know, we'll see where it takes me, but hopefully I got this year and 1 more year left.
You're going to get another year, you think, because of the injuries?
Yeah, I sat out all last year I got my ACL repaired, so I didn't touch the mat at all my senior year.
And it's usually 2 consecutive years of injuries, and then you were under 20% of the season or whatever they do whenever you wrestle a little bit of the season, right?
I didn't even touch the mat.
Not even touch it at all, huh?
Yeah.
So you got a pretty good chance of getting another year back.
Yeah.
What's your first degree in from Buffalo?
So I was social study interdisciplinary. I was mental health and a minor in counseling.
You have a major and a minor? You have two.
And then I'm going for my master's in business, so MBA.
MBA from CSU?
Yep.
Dude, you're going to have like 7 degrees by the time it's all said and done.
Yeah, might as well.
And okay, so what's next? Do you go back to PA? Do you stay in Cleveland, or just wherever business takes you?
Well, right now that's my issue, because my dad yells at me. I'm kind of a go-with-the-flow kind of guy. I know I still got this year and 1 more year of schooling. So right now my head's on wrestling. Gotta work in the summer, try to get some, exposure under me in the job fields and see where it goes. I don't know where I'll end up, but.
John Stutzman and Josh Moore are just 2 really different guys.
Yeah.
What's the style change been like for you to go from Stutzman, I call him Nutzman, I gave him that nickname if you didn't know, him to Josh Moore? What's that transition been like for you?
It was a smooth transition, they left on good terms with everything. Just different styles of wrestling. Buffalo, as many know, hands-on, get in your face, brawl, wear out a guy. Kind of here, it's more you create your own style. We coach around what you're good at. They know what I'm good at. I'm more slick, out in the open kind of guy. So to my advantage, that works for me with this coaching staff. And they've been able to, you know, help me a lot in transition with my attacks. And I mean, it's been working out, so couldn't be happier right now.
Boomer coming along. You know, yeah. Boomer was over there with you for how many of the years was he over there with you?
At least two.
Two of the year, right? Yeah. So that's got to be comfortable having a guy that bridged the gap, right? It's not just a bunch of, I don't know any of these people, right? Yeah. Was Boomer a big part of it, do you think?
Huge. He's like a role model to me. I look up to him. Great guy, works with me. That was a big thing when I was at Buffalo. Me and him got off to a great relationship right away. And ever since, when he left, it was parting ways and nothing, you know, no beef or anything. And then, so I was in the portal and jumped right on it, you know, got me out on a visit. I loved it. And then here I am.
I see the New Era shirt on you. Yeah. You guys, they lost to Kent last year. You weren't on the team. You were at Buffalo.
Yeah.
They haven't beat Kent in like, probably like 17, 18 years.
What's it
like getting the win over Kent? I mean, Kent got a team point taken away for control of Matt, but you guys probably would have still won on criteria.
Criteria, yeah. So it would have came down. It was huge. I know how in-state rivals goes because at Buffalo it's us, Binghamton, stuff like that. So here it's you know, the Ohio's, the Ohio State's, and we're trying to be the second best team because, you know, right now we know Ohio State's far-fetched, but that's what the goal to work on. But it was huge, especially with Coach Moore coaching here, whether or not it was personal or not. But in-state rival, commitment. So it was a huge win for us. And to be part of it for the first time in, you know, a decade and a half, it's pretty awesome. So couldn't be happier. And team fought hard, came down to everyone. So everyone
and a throw with the last 3 seconds was what won an ultimate. Yeah. Two riding time points.
Yep.
Won two matches. You realize that, right? 57 and 25.
Yep.
All right. You got anything else for me?
No, I appreciate it, man.
All right, man. Thanks for the time. Right. Keep grinding. I will see you in Minneapolis.
Sounds good. Go, bud.